Howdy, friends and family. My name is Mark Tanzer. I graduated Lafayette College, class of 2011. And over the next month, I'm going to be creating a series of YouTube videos in preparation and in celebration of the Lafayette College against Lehigh University, the Lafayette-Lehigh big rivalry game on November 22nd, 2014. This is going to be the 150th football matchup between the two schools, which, while it's not the oldest matchup, it's actually the rivalry with the most number of games played, because some of the Ivy League schools, they've been around longer as far as the rivalries go, Harvard, Princeton, Yale, teams like that. But for the first, I don't know, 20, 30 some odd years of the Lafayette-Lehigh rivalry, they actually played two games per year instead of one, making this 150th game the most played rivalry in American college football history. In celebration of it, I'm going to be making this series of videos discussing a whole litany of issues and topics from Lafayette College and Lehigh University, as well as the rivalry and faculty and administration and opinions on that stuff, as well as whole other series of issues that I like to talk about, rant about, local news, national news, some local and national and other regional politics. So I'll be doing that, and I'll be doing that while drinking a Yuengling Lager, again, in commemoration of this great rivalry, as Yuengling is the oldest American brewery and is in Pottsville, Pennsylvania, which is just a little bit outside of the Lehigh Valley in Pennsylvania. So I'm kind of celebrating the greatness of that area of Pennsylvania in general. So let's get started. I just have a couple things to discuss in this video, and then my subsequent videos should get really a lot of fun. But first, I want to discuss my plans for November 22nd, which is the day of the big game, which, by the way, is being held at Yankee Stadium. So I've already been preparing for this day for over a year from now. So maybe 13, 14, 15 months. I've been talking about it, telling people, and I already have those days off, that Saturday and Sunday, and even that Friday. I took off from work. I gave notice, not a month notice or 6 months notice, but over a year notice. So my boss was well aware. Anyway, my plans for that Saturday, my dad actually came up with that. He's actually also a Lafayette alum, graduated class of 1979 with a biology degree. So he put these plans in motion, and I'm kind of just going along for the ride. We are tailgating behind his office in Little Ferry, New Jersey. A bunch of his alumni friends, as well as some of my alumni friends, we will be tailgating behind his office, and then we're taking a bus. My dad is renting a bus, and we're taking it into the city, right to the Bronx, to Yankee Stadium. So it should be a lot of fun that day. Really looking forward to it. As I said, I've been looking forward to it for quite a long time now. Just a quick comment. If any of my friends are watching this, although all the tickets that my dad bought are all accounted for and we don't have any tickets left, we still do have a handful of bus seats left. So if anybody who has a ticket would like to join us for the tailgate and for the ride into the city, you're more than welcome to. Please just let me know, and I'll confirm that you can come, and it'll be a lot of fun. I have to imagine we'll probably get a keg of this, or a half keg probably, as well as some other interesting and good stuff. What else did I want to talk about? I guess I already discussed the rivalry briefly, 150th game. It's been around since the 1800s, been around for a long time. And let me tell you, there's something about the rivalry. Lafayette College students, We go to a lot of the Lafayette football games, especially if they're at home. I went to a lot of them. I probably went to every single one as a freshman, every single home game, as well as one or two of the away games. But the rivalry game is different. It's special. And there's kind of an aura that surrounds the campus starting the night before. Really, the entire week, there's stuff going on. But really, the night before, things get started. And then all through that Saturday, which is the rivalry day, whether it's on the campus of Lafayette College or 20 minutes away at the Lehigh University campus, it's really a special time for both campuses, for students of both colleges. What else did I want to discuss? I guess briefly about Yuengling. As I did mention, it is America's oldest brewery. It's in Pottsville, Pennsylvania, and they started brewing it in 1829. So it's been around for even longer than the Lafayette-Lehigh football rivalry has been around. In fact, I think Lafayette College was chartered sometime in the 1820s, and its first classes were late 1820s, early 1830s, something like that. I should have looked it up beforehand, but that's okay. Considering this is my first YouTube video, I think I'm doing all right. So, anything else about Yuengling? This is the traditional lager. It's an amber lager. It's kind of a clearish, tannish red. It's really delicious. It's by far my favorite beer, and I'm not even much of a beer drinker since the end of college. During college, I drank plenty, but since getting out, drink a couple beers a month maybe. Not a very big beer drinker, especially considering I'm not very good with gluten these days. So, but I figured for the month before the big rivalry game, who cares? Let's see. I covered most of the issues that I specifically wanted to cover for this video. I want to cover one more issue. And then right before that, though, I do want to make a mention of a couple quick things. Upcoming, I will be discussing a whole array of issues that I had mentioned at the beginning of the video. One thing I don't think I mentioned is that one of my plans is to try to get some friends from college to do some sort of a video chat. And if we could record the entire video chat and get that into a YouTube video, hopefully with all of them also drinking some Yuenglings. I will talk with them about that in the upcoming few days, I'm sure. I did want to spend the rest of the video on one of the issues that I had thought of a few days ago when I first thought of this idea. I can rant plenty against the Lafayette College administration, but let me tell you something, the Lafayette College faculty, second to none. I graduated with a degree in mathematics and economics. As I said, my dad graduated with a degree in biology. He still keeps in contact with a professor emeritus, Dr. Freed, in the biology department. He also still keeps in contact with Professor J. Larry Stockton in the music department. My dad was the drum major of the marching band back when we did have a marching band. And I will tip my hat to Lehigh University for their marching 97. They do, admittedly, do a very nice job. Unfortunately, we don't have that anymore. We don't have a marching band. But my dad still keeps in contact with at least a couple of them. I've been out of college for about 3.5 years now. I still keep in contact with a bunch of the professors that I had, as well as one or two that I didn't even have for a class, but I just knew them from various things. So, first of all, in the mathematics department, I want to give a shout out to the first math professor I had, who's now retired. I'm not sure if he's emeritus and still around or if he's gone, but that would be Chester Salwack, who I had Calculus 1 with. Excuse me, Calculus 2 as a first semester freshman. I didn't take Calculus 1. His class, I did pretty well in the class as far as I remember, and he was just a very good professor. He was a good instructor. He was very clear on what he wanted, as well as he was able to teach the material very clearly, which for Calculus 2 isn't easy. Fortunately for me, he did not give a full exam on series and sequences. He just integrated that unit as part of the final. If he had, I would not have done nearly as well in the class because for some reason I just could not get series and sequences. Even though they're probably not that hard, I just couldn't get them. But he really was great. Another math professor, probably the best that I had, was for a class that didn't even fulfill a requirement for my major or a requirement or an elective. I took it because I didn't have any other math class to take when I was a senior during my fall semester, and that was Professor Justin Corvino. I took differential equations, Math 264, with him. The class was pretty much all sophomore engineers, as well as one junior, who I completely coincidentally happened to have been friends with. He had to retake the class, unfortunately. But I loved the class. I enjoyed it. I got tons out of it. It was insane how much I learned. And Justin Corvino, just like Chester Salwak, he had a teaching style that was just really, really cool. Very, very clear. He was able to take difficult subjects and really somehow make you understand them. The assignments that he gave were always really appropriate, and it wasn't overdoing it, but it was the right kind of assignments, so it's not like working harder, it's working smarter. And I think that's something to his credit that, I mean, I'm here 3.5 years later talking about a class that I wasn't even really a mandatory for my major or contributed to my major at all. I just took it. Even though it was a math class, it didn't have anything to do with the mathematics and economics major. But the fact that I'm talking about it now, I think gives a testament to how great the subject is and especially how great of an instructor Justin Corvino is. I did really like all the math professors I had. I had Sean Kimber for linear algebra. I had Larry Thomas Hill for, what did I have him for? Math modeling. And I had Chin Liu for Calculus 3, as well as I audited financial math that she taught. I had Rob Root for statistics, and I had Jeff Liebner for probability. And really, all those people were really, really great. I really loved their classes. I feel like I'm missing a couple of them, but I can't think of them. So I do apologize to them. But the entire math department, I hope you guys keep it up. I hope the administration supports you more than my perception suggests that they've supported you. One other person I didn't mention, Derek Smith, who's also in the math department. I had him for my sophomore VAST class, Values in Science and Technology, writing class, and I took his gambling here and everywhere class, and it was really, really fun. We learned probability and statistics on the various casino games. We learned some psychology about gambling, which we had a guest lecture by, what was his name? The professor who was also the faculty advisor for WJRH. The name escapes me at the moment, but I'll put that in the next video if I can't think of it by the end of this video. And his lecture was really great. I also want to mention a few professors in the econ department, who I don't even have written down. I'm just pretty much staring at this blank piece of paper. In the econ department, I had Professor... who did I have? I had Professor James DeVault and Julie Smith for my advanced monetary policy class in conjunction with Fed Challenge. They were really cool. Julie Smith seems to be a little bit more pro-liberty and pro-free markets than James DeVault, and I am a big libertarian, so I can appreciate that. But James DeVault was really cool. I've actually met with both of them the past 3 times I visited campus in either September or October, each of the past 3 years after college, and they're very friendly, and they really want to talk, and they love talking with me, I love talking with them, and even James DeVault, though he's a little bit of a statist, he's still very open, and he really likes talking about the issues and about what's going on in the economy. Who else? I had Professor Michael Kelly for Intro to Finance, which was one of the best classes I took in college. I would say specifically the one subject area that's applicable to everybody through all their lives is discounting by interest rates. And I think that it's something that, unfortunately, a lot of my friends didn't get to take that class and learn that subject, specifically discounting by interest rates. But it's really, really important for planning and decision making in the future with money. And his class was great. I learned a lot. And I definitely appreciated a lot of the things that he talked about in class. Another professor who I love in the econ department, who unfortunately I did not take, he taught a few classes, including Intro to Finance, but it didn't work out in my schedule for me to take Intro to Finance with him, was Professor Donald Chambers. And I've met with him each of the three times I've visited campus, even though I never even had him. I spoke with him a few times on campus, and he actually administers the Whitman Fund, which is an alumnus's fund, an alumnus named Whitman. He donated to fund interns to work at various educational organizations and think tanks during summer and perhaps winter breaks. And because of Donald Chambers administering the Whitman Fund, I was able to work at, as well as Professor Chambers' connections with these organizations, I was able to intern at the Institute for Humane Studies in Arlington, Virginia, as well as the Foundation for Economic Education in Irvington-on-Hudson in New York, right on the Hudson River. And both of those internships were really cool. So, and Donald Chambers, he's a huge libertarian. I love talking with him. I've heard his classes are really wonderful from friends who were conservative, even liberal friends. They say they always got a laugh because he would give examples of why prostitution should be legal and why drugs should be legal and all the standard libertarian things, which we don't have to be enamored with those particular things, but we certainly believe that prohibitions are certainly a negative and very bad. So Professor Chambers, I certainly think he got a lot of my peers who took his class to think about these issues and to think about liberty in general. And I think Lafayette College and the world is better for people like Professor Donald Chambers. So, Professor Chambers, I love you. Keep on keeping on. Keep on doing what you're doing. Who else did I have in the econ department? I had Professor Susan Averett for econometric analysis. She was really, really wonderful. Great class. I did pretty well in her class. I think I got actually an A. And it was kind of writing intensive with some econometric analysis. You had to write regressions and do research and compile your own data, which was really cool, but I loved her class. I actually did my term paper on gun control, and I did well on that, and she enjoyed the paper. I had Professor David Stifel for applied microeconometrics, as well as, microeconometric analysis, as well as intermediate microeconomics. And he had a teaching style. He was really, really clear, very good. It helped that I had taken calculus and I had that calculus background when I was taking microeconometrics. But really, really good class. And anybody who has to take intermediate microeconometrics, if Professor David Stifel is teaching it, I highly recommend that you take it with him. I forget if I got a B. I think I got an A- in the class. But just really, really good. He probably made it as exciting as he could have given the subject material. So I got to give him credit. And I'm sure there are a couple of econ professors who I'm omitting who I really did enjoy. One more real quick, Gladstone Flooney Hutchinson. I really enjoyed his macroeconomics class. And I haven't seen him since he went away to do some things at a foreign university, or he was working for a foreign government. I forget the details, but I know he's been around, but I happen to have missed him every time I was on campus since I graduated. But he was also really great. And then just a couple other quick shout-outs, because another video is running very long, and I haven't even finished my beer yet, so let me just put another dent into that. want to give a shout out to a couple people in the government and law department. Unfortunately, he was just a visiting professor when I was a freshman and sophomore, but David Gauthier, I really loved his two classes. I took him for Intro to Political Theory, and I also took him for Modern Political Theory. And it was kind of the concept of the classes were simple. We did some readings, we discussed the readings in class, and then we had to write essay exams on them. But I learned tons from his classes. From his intro class, I know we read Machiavelli, we read Plato, we read Aristotle, we read more of a modern writer, Jean Bethke Elstein, who I know my buddy Aaron still has my book. But that was a great book. Let's see if I can look on my shelf. In my modern political theory class with him, we read Hobbes, we read Locke. As we were reading John Locke, the bank bailouts were going on in the fall of 08, and between that and reading Locke and a few other things going on, that's kind of what helped me become a libertarian. So that was really cool. Who else? I had Professor Ilan Peleg for, I think, one class for Middle East politics, and enjoyable class. I think he hit the nail on the head. It's not that he predicted with certainty, but he certainly had some prescience to suggest that there was a lot of instability going on, specifically in Egypt, I remember. He might have mentioned other places, but back in, it was probably 2010 or 2009, he had mentioned a lot of problems with Egypt, and then a couple years later, what was it, 2012, I think after I graduated, that's when things started falling apart with Egypt, and they had the revolutions and the whatever it is that went on there. I was following it at the time, but there have been so many other things since then between Libya and Syria and now Iraq with ISIS, so I kind of lose track of things. I just know that he was kind of right on point. And then Professor Kotlin Fabian, I had her for Intro to International Politics, and while she is a socialist, and as far as one of my friends told me, she actually ran on a socialist party ticket in some European country back, I don't know, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, I don't really know. I think around the time of the fall of the Soviet Union. In spite of that, I think she was a really good professor. She certainly wasn't, she didn't penalize me or anybody else for having different opinions, and I certainly think that she enjoyed hearing other people's opinions as long as they were willing to participate and could back up their arguments, so I certainly enjoyed her class. And I think that the government law department is stronger for having Ilan Peleg and Kotlin Fabian. I wish they had kept David Gauthier. I'm not sure if he wanted to stay or not, but he was really cool as well. So I'm about to finish my beer, and I think that's just about it. I apologize for the video running much longer than I wanted to. Most of these videos I want to keep around 10 minutes, but it's going to be hard because I like to rant. So, but you can expect some really cool videos coming up about various issues. I don't know what else to say. I'm going to be covering some info about the Lehigh Valley and what makes the Lehigh Valley and surrounding areas really cool. That's going to be probably in tomorrow's video. I'm also going to be covering, as I said, some international politics, specifically the governor race here in Florida. My buddy, who I mentioned before, Aaron, who was in my who took political theory at the same time that I did, he's running for an interesting office up in Pennsylvania. I'm going to be covering his race a little bit. I'm going to be covering a proposition, a ballot initiative up in New York, as well as actually a couple of them right down here in Florida, in addition to the governor's race. Some other local and national politics, some local and national news I'll be talking about and ranting about, giving my opinion on. And as I said before, I hope that some of my friends will be able to video chat and get that uploaded as well. So, challenge to you guys, go out and get a rack of Yuengling, and we'll start this soon. Have a good night, y'all.